Good morning, students. Today we are going to see exercise 6.6. Continue with exercise 6.6. So you are seen with the formulae how to find out the vector and Cartesian equation of the plane. So now we are going to see with problem number 2 in exercise 6.6. Find the direction cosines of the normal to the plane. The plane equation is given here as 12x plus 3y minus 4 is equal to 65. Okay. Also, find the non-parametric form of vector equation of a plane and the length of the perpendicular to the plane from the origin. So, listen carefully. There are three questions asked. One is find the direction cosines. Another one is find the non-parametric vector equation. And the third one is length of the perpendicular to the plane from the origin. Okay. So, first step is we can write the given equation of the plane in the form of r vector dot n cap equal to p. So, how can you write this r vector dot? This is the equation of the plane. So, what is the normal vector means? Normal vector replacing x, y, z by I, j and k. So 3j cap minus 4k cap divided by what is a normal vector n cap? Normal vector is 12i plus 3j minus 4k, but n cap is n vector by modulus of n vector. So we have to take the squares, 12 square plus 3 square plus 4 square. So we are taking this side with the denominator like this. So, we are going to take this side also with the denominator. Root of 12 square plus 3 square plus 4 square. Okay. Minus 4 the whole square will become as 4 square. So, what's the answer now? R vector dot 12 I cap plus 3 j cap minus 4 k cap divided by root of 144 plus 9 plus 16. So, it is nothing but root 169. Here also it will be 65 divided by root 169. Okay. So, now let us, what is root 169? It is 13, isn't it? So, r vector dot 12i cap plus 3j cap minus 4k cap divided by 13. So, what is 65 by 13? It is 5. So, now we are going to give the answer for question number 1. Direction cosines. Direction cosines are nothing but the component of n cap. That is 12 by 13, comma 3 by 13, comma minus 4 by 13. So, these are the direction cosines. Second question is asked with non-parametric vector equation. Non-parametric vector equation. Non-parametric vector equation is the equation we found at last. That is r vector dot 12 I cap plus 3 j cap minus 4 k cap divided by 13 is equal to 5. So, this is non-parametric vector equation. Question number 3, it is asked with length of the perpendicular, length of the perpendicular to the plane from the origin, to the plane from the origin. So, what is the length of the perpendicular from the, it is from the, to the plane from the origin is q. So, the equation is can be written as r vector dot n cap is equal to q. Therefore, the value for q is equal to 5 units. Therefore, the length of the perpendicular to the plane from the origin is 5 units. Okay. So, with this, we are finished with sub problem number 2. Now, let us go with problem number 3. Okay. Now, let us go with problem number 3. Find the vector and Cartesian equation of the plane passing through the point with the position vector. So point means that is A. Position vector means OA vector, that is nothing but A vector, is given as 2i cap plus 6j cap plus 3k cap. And normal to the vector, normal to the vector means n vector. So I cap plus 3j cap plus 5k cap. So these two are given. We need to find out the vector and Cartesian equation of the plane. So let us find out first vector equation. What is the vector equation formula? That is r vector dot n vector is equal to a vector dot n vector. This is nothing but the formula you have seen, r minus a dot n is equal to 0. So r dot n minus a dot n equal to 0. Minus a dot n can be taken to that side. So we can write this as r vector dot n vector is I cap plus 3j cap plus 5k cap is equal to a vector is 2i cap plus 6j cap plus 3k cap dot n vector is I cap plus 3j cap plus 5k cap. So what's the answer now? 2 into 1, 2 plus 3 into 6, 18 plus 3 into 5, 15. So your answer will be 17 plus 18, 35. So this is the vector equation, r vector dot I cap plus 3j cap plus 5k cap is equal to 35 is the vector equation. Next one, let us find out the Cartesian equation. To write down the Cartesian equation, we no need to memorize anything. Instead of r vector, we can substitute xi plus yj plus zk dot I cap plus 3j cap plus 5k cap is equal to 35. So when you find out the dot product between these two vectors, the answer will be x plus 3y plus 5k, sorry 5z is equal to 35 is the required equation of the required Cartesian equation of the plane. So plane oda equation kuduthu n vector elutha sonnanga, normal vector kandupidikano appadina x y z edala replace pananum, I j k ala replace pananum n vector kedachirum. Namakku r vector dot n vector is equal to p nu therinjuchu appadina we can change r vector as xi plus yj plus zk and find out the dot product to write down the Cartesian equation. Okay, so now let us move to problem number 4. So problem number 4, a plane passes through the point minus 1, 1, 2 and the normal to the plane of magnitude. So magnitude value is given as, magnitude value is given as 3 root 3. Makes equal acute angles with the coordinate axis. So it is given the normal vector make equal acute angle with the coordinate axis. Find the equation of the plane. So this vector can be written as a vector is equal to minus I cap plus j cap plus 2k cap. And also it is given normal vector makes equal acute angle with the coordinate axis. With the coordinate axis. Okay. So we know that already. We know that cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to 1. Illaya? Idu namakku theriyum. Ipa equal angles nu solrirukanaala alpha equal to beta equal to gamma. Appa alpha beta gamma ellame equal na we can write it as 3 cos square alpha equal to 1. Appa cos square alpha is equal to 1 by 3. Appa what is cos alpha? Cos alpha equal to 1 by root 3 அப்படின்னு கிடைக்குது. சரியா? அப்ப நமக்கு இப்ப n வெக்டார் கண்டுபிடிக்கணும் பிகாஸ் we need to find out the equation of the plane. A வெக்டார் கொடுத்திருக்காங்க, ஒரு மேக்னிடியூட் வேல்யூ கொடுத்திருக்காங்க. Now we need to find out n வெக்டார். அப்ப n வெக்டார் is equal to மேக்னிடியூட் வேல்யூ வந்து 3√3. இத மல்டிப்ளை பண்ணிக்கோ. மல்டிப்ளை பண்ணிட்டு i cap plus j cap plus k cap இல்லையா divided by √3. This is also √3 and this is also √3. ஏனா நமக்கு வந்து இப்ப cos alpha 1/√3 னா cos beta வும் என்னது 1/√3, cos gamma is also 1/√3. அப்ப direction cosines are 1/√3, 1/√3, 1/√3. அப்ப we can write it as i/√3, j/√3, k/√3 plus. Okay, so this can be taken as √3 நம்ம காமனா எடுத்தோம்னா கேன்சல் பண்ணிரலாம். So you are getting the answer as 3i cap plus 3j cap plus 3k cap. So this is n vector and we know what is a vector. So we can write down the vector equation. Vector equation is r vector dot n vector is equal to a vector dot n vector. So r vector we can write it as r vector dot 3i cap plus 3j cap plus 3k cap is equal to minus i cap plus j cap plus 2k cap dot 3i cap plus 3j cap plus 3k cap. So when you are finding the dot product, minus 3 plus 3 plus 6, so your answer will be 6, equal to 6. So you can write this as dividing by 2, we can write this as, we can leave it as it is. Now the Cartesian equation is, we can substitute for r vector as xi, yj, zk, isn't it? What will be the answer? 3x plus 3y plus 3z is equal to 6. That implies we can divide by 3 and write down the equation as x plus y plus z equal to 2 is the equation of plane. We need to find out the equation of the plane. So this is the equation of the plane. Okay. So we have find out what is the equation of the plane. Okay. Now let us go to problem number 5. It is a very easiest question. Find the intercepts cut off the plane on the coordinate axis. So you can make the equation of the plane by the given equation 6x plus 4y minus 3z equal to 12. Divide the equation by 12. You will get the intercepts in the denominator of x, y, z. That will be the intercepts we have to find out. So take it as homework. Now let us go to problem number 6. Problem number 6. Problem number 6. It is if a plane meets the coordinate axis at A, B and C such that the centroid of the triangle ABC is the point U, V, W, find the equation of the plane. So plane means we need three axes, isn't it? So let us make x, y and z with center as origin. It meets the coordinate axis at the point A, B and C. So let us take A, B and C. Okay. So here the point A will be A, 0, 0. Here it is on y axis, so 0, B, 0. It is on z axis, so 0, 0, C. So let us write down, let a, 0, 0, b, 0, b, 0, c, 0, 0, c, be the points meet the coordinate axis. Okay, we have taken the three points as A, B, C and it is given like this. So what is the centroid? Centroid is centroid of triangle ABC. it is a plus 0 plus 0 by 3, that is a by 3. Similarly, 0 plus b plus 0 by 3, that is b by 3. Third point is c by 3. So this is the centroid of the triangle. It is given that the centroid of the triangle is the point UVW. So given centroid is UVW. So we can equate the centroid we found and the given centroid. So A by 3 equal to U. B by 3 is equal to V. C by 3 is equal to W. So what is A is equal to 3U, B is equal to 3V and C is equal to 3W. So how can you write the intercept form of the plane? So equation of the plane in intercept form is, equation of plane is X by A plus Y by B plus Z by C is equal to 1. So in the place of A, B, C, we are going to substitute X by 3U plus Y by 3V plus Z by 3W is equal to 1. So taking 3 to that side, we will get X by U plus Y by V plus Z by W is equal to 3. So this is the required equation of the plane when it passes through the when the centroid is the point UVW. So with this, the exercise 6.6 is over. So in the next class, students, we are going to see with exercise 6.7. So complete your homework. Homework with problem number 5. So complete your homework and we shall continue the class tomorrow with exercise 6.7. Thank you.